prophet, y'all know the psychic and the tennis pastor, coming back at you again with another video. People already told y'all, and I'm preaching this, I'm going with dependability in this Wimbledon. It's not always that way. Sometimes there's upsets of the major players, but I think this is the year. Whoever wins the Wimbledon this year, I don't think it's going to be any surprises. Okay? Like I said before, and it's only a few, it's only two or three dependable players. I already told y'all, Federer, Nadal. I know the other week I was questioning whether the Djokovic is dependable, but I think the Djokovic is dependable. But people, that's pretty well it. And I mean, I'm going to do a video. Is Kyrgios dependable now? But y'all saw what just happened to Chilich. We're not going with anybody that's not dependable. At least I'm not. I'm going with only dependable players. And if I'm wrong, okay, I'll be wrong. I'm not betting on anybody in this Wimbledon who's not dependable. And what I call dependable is that you have won the Wimbledon multiple times. That's dependable. Not even a little dependable, okay? And then Nadal won his second round match. Nadal looking good, taking care of business in straight sets the way he is supposed to. Like I said, it's going to get interesting, man. Nadal versus the Djokovic, or Nadal versus Kyrgios. Boy, it's some interesting stuff that's going to happen. But like I said before, I'm rolling with the most dependable player. Okay, that's what I'm looking for. Dependability. All right. But get back to Nadal, though. There's not really that much to say about Nadal. I already said in another match, man. I told y'all Nadal was... I'm predicting Nadal is going to have a good Wimbledon. I'm not sure here. I'm not sure if Nadal will win the whole thing. He has a chance of winning. He has a good chance of winning the whole thing. He's playing well enough to win the whole thing. But I don't think this is not going to be some early exit. I mean, if I'm wrong about that, I would totally admit that I was wrong. I don't think this is definitely not looking like it's going to be that early exit Nadal from the Wimbledon. This looked like a Nadal that wants to win the Wimbledon, and like a Nadal that's probably going to make it definitely to the semis and probably to the final. Okay, and but we have to see, though. I mean, he got to deal with the Djokovic and Kyrgios, all right. And but yeah, man, Nadal is doing his thing, and I think Nadal has, you know, people, I forgot, we know Nadal's won it twice, but people, Nadal, even though I was preaching long for months that Nadal could win the Wimbledon, that he could win 18 here, it's highly possible. People, Nadal, he was in five consecutive Wimbledon finals. I didn't realize it was five consecutive. So anybody that say Nadal can't win on grass or Nadal can't play well on grass, they crazy, okay? Tennis preacher, prophet, psychic. I will be previewing the next match, whoever Nadal is playing next. I do that tomorrow. But yeah, I'm expecting Nadal to keep winning in straight sets, at least until he get the really, really, really tougher players. And he may even raise the level against them and take them out in three or four sets, okay? It's going to get really interesting. The one thing I do see is that Nadal is definitely putting pressure on Federer to keep his level high and even take it higher. Because if Federer's level drop, Nadal will beat him if they meet in the final. Okay? All right? Well, if Federer's level drop, he may not even make it to the final. I'm not saying his level going to drop, but definitely Federer better be looking over on this side of the draw where Nadal is and saying, man, I better keep my level up. Nadal is on the game. He's playing as well on the grass as he played on clay. Okay, people, tennis preacher, prophet, psychic, signing off. Have a good one.